I grew up in a pretty typical Australian household. Didn't go to church, didn't read the Bible. And although I didn't, you know God or know Jesus or know the ways of God, I knew that there was something more that I was seeking. And I really was on a journey of trying to find out if the answers were in another country, in another culture. As I started to talk to people and spend time with people and other backpackers, I found out that we're all out there searching and we're all out there trying to find purpose and why we're here. No matter where I went, I met people just like me when I thought I would meet people who had it all together. And so then I ended up going to New Zealand. All my family's from New Zealand, and so I thought, okay, I'll go over and see some family and also do some, you know, work over there on a ski field. So I met a cousin, and she was a Christian, and she told me a lot about God and a lot about God's ways and what Christianity was and what it looked like. And I remember saying to her, oh, I think I'll be a Christian one day, but not yet. So at that time as well, I was involved with a guy who I'd met on the mountain, and I remember asking her, is it okay if he comes and visits me before I go back to Australia? And she had to go away and pray about it with her housemates. And during that time I said to God, God, if you let, you know, him come and stay, I promise I'll learn something new about you. And so she came back to me and said, yes, he can come and stay, but he has to come to church the next day. So the next morning we went to church with my cousin and the worship started. And I was just touched by the Holy Spirit. I felt just very emotionally overwhelmed. I just started weeping during worship. So it scared me a bit, and so I pulled back a little bit. I remember leaving the church service and I said, I've just had too much Jesus. I knew I had been moved by the service and by the Holy Spirit, but I just said, no, that's too much. I moved back to Brisbane, ended up getting a job in a charity organization. And so that was another answered prayer that I really thought, oh wow, like that was something that my cousin prayed for and it happened. And in the same job, I met a Christian girl, and she was my age, and she was just really friendly, really lively. And I remember asking her one day, oh, what are you doing this weekend? And she said, I'm going to church. I'm like, oh, you're religious? And she's like, no, I live for God. And I'm like, oh, I don't know if I've heard it that way. I also started watching this American preacher on TV, and I asked my friend one day, you know, if she's going to church. She said, yeah, she's like, this American preacher is coming. I was like, oh, can I come? I've seen her on TV. And so of course she was just excited that I wanted to go to church. I went back, kept going back for a couple of months. I think it was not long after that, I ended up walking up when the preacher, you know, did the altar call, and I just walked up and I just knew that God was who I was looking for this whole time, and it just felt so right. I felt at peace. I didn't feel restless. I just felt so excited for what the future could hold. And so I wish I had have done that a year earlier, but I didn't, and I would have saved myself a lot of pain during that year. I just was really, really ready when I gave my life to God. Haven't felt that restlessness anymore. I have that peace now, and I have the purpose that I was looking for. My purpose is to love God and to have relationship with God and to be loved by God and just walk in that relationship into all that He has for me to do.